you're talking about the rebounding. I mean, there was a point in the game, just a weird stat, where Rob Williams had the most field goal attempts on the team and Kemba Walker was the leading rebounder. Kemba Walker was the team's leading rebounder heading into the fourth quarter and was finally surpassed by Tatum. He finished with 8 rebounds and 7 assists. That's a pretty... Yeah. You know,
on,
as you
on
said,
both ends of the floor, it's he's a different getting game. Into the thick of it.
Where he's suffering is in the shooting department, where he's just had, especially from behind the arc, has been a real slog for about a 10-12 game stretch here that's just been dragging down his numbers. And I think that's the stuff that freaks people out, because they're just like, he's not doing it. He's not. But again, what you're looking at with Kemba, his involvement, his energy, his mobility, you know, those are the things you look for. He's always been a streaky sort of shooter. If you look at his career numbers, he's always low 40s in general field goal percentage with a 3-point percentage somewhere in the high 30s. That's what you're getting here. He's just a tick below those numbers this year. It's not ridiculously low. It just is inefficient. You know, that little difference makes a difference if he's going to be jacking 18, 20 shots a game and they're losing. So this is the type of Kemba you want to see. I mean, he knocked down a couple of big threes in this one. As you said, the passing, moving, whipping the ball around, you know, he was part of the flow. It felt like he was in the flow today instead of just like, all right, I'm going to try to do Kemba things right now. You know, it's felt, the efforts felt disjointed at times throughout the season. This didn't feel like it.
Yeah.
Right, and that's the biggest difference. Like Kemba, when Kemba is down on himself, it seems like, or at least it felt to me throughout the course of the regular season, he starts not being engaged as much, you know, whether it's grabbing those extra rebounds or just penetrating and keeping the ball in your hands or keeping guys involved. That's the difference that we're seeing now, because now he's getting people the ball where they like it. He gets the ball back and he's keeping himself engaged. You know, we talked about it before. When he's ice cold throughout the first half, he's still capable to go off in that second half. We've seen that before throughout, you know, his tenure here in Boston and throughout his career, essentially. And I think the biggest difference this season, or at least right now in particular, the last few games or so, is that at least in this West Coast road trip, one, there isn't the back-to-backs, right? So we're going to see more Kemba where he's not going to be in and out of, you know, having to be forced to sit out. And two, he's going to be engaged more because now that the ball is swinging more and now that we're seeing Celtics get more opportunities for not only Kemba but for Robert Williams and for Tatum, that he's not going to just shy away. I mean, that's what used to worry me before, where it seemed like if Kemba missed a few three-pointers, he felt like he couldn't find another way to be effective, or he was down on himself and he didn't want to step on Jason Tatum or Jaylen Brown's toes. But now everyone's encouraging one another, and that's a huge difference I'm seeing, especially in that starting five. That's why I think it's so important for him to be out there, of course, and not having to sit out at least for these next week or so, since the Celtics don't have another back-to-back coming up anytime soon. I mean, it's so important for him to get more comfortable with that starting lineup, of course, with Marcus Smart back, and of course with Robert Williams anchoring that starting five.